7th of August will again be a red letter day in the history of our bioethics unit when we have Dr. Vikas Agarwal speaking on one of the most sensitive issues which concerns bioethics, and that's organ donation. So we must applaud the bioethics unit for this work and also Dr. Agarwal. Ladies and gentlemen, I now request the captain of the ship, the source of inspiration for all SDTNs and also the organizer of today's program, Dr. Shyamlal Singla, Pro-Chancellor SDT University, to kindly extend a welcome to the August gathering. Dr. Singla.
One of the top leading urologists of North India, Dr. Vikas Agarwal, who is doing pioneering work in renal transplantation. And since its basic subject is on transplantation, he will be talking more on our own awareness. We were just walking across from the office towards this lecture theater. One of our senior faculty member asked few questions. What are these donors and where are they available? So that speaks of our awareness. That means we are really very poorly aware what transplantation is. Hence it's required, since we are in this profession, that we all get tuned to what is a transplantation and what is renal transplantation. And for this, it's right time. Let's not waste time on this, to have Vikas Agarwal on the stage. Thank you very much.
Dr. Vikas Agarwal is a senior consultant and head urology and renal transplant at the VPS Rockland Hospital and Max Healthcare Hospital, Shalimar Bagh. Dr. Agarwal completed his MBBS and MS in general surgery from Pandit BDS Postgraduate Institute of Medical Sciences, Rohtak, and completed his DNB in genitourinary surgery from the Mulji Bhai Patel Urological Hospital, Naidyad, and he cleared his DNB exam in the first attempt. Dr. Agarwal's areas of special interest include laparoscopic urology, endourology, renal transplant surgery, and uro-oncology and robotics. His research project during DNB was the role of contrast-enhanced ultrasound for characterization of small renal mass. Dr. Agarwal has a vast experience and has worked in the various prestigious medical institutes and hospitals, including the Medanta Medicity Gurgaon, Indraprastha Apollo Hospital, Delhi, Artemis Health Institute, Gurgaon, and Pandit B.D. Sharma Postgraduate Institute of Medical Sciences, Rohtak. He has presented various papers and videos in national and international conferences and has conducted and attended various workshops, continuing medical education programs, and conferences in India and abroad. Dr. Agarwal is a member of the various prestigious international and national associations, including the Urological Society of India, American Urological Association, and West Zone Urological Society. So ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Dr. Vikas Agarwal.
Good afternoon all. Thank you very much for this warm welcome and so much great introduction, which I never expected. And especially I would like to thank all the university, SGT University, who has given me this opportunity to interact you with all, and especially Dr. Shyam Singla, who is right now in the, we can say in the SGT, but he is our Rohtkis. And it will not be exaggerated. Today what I am is because of him. Because like you, when I was in MBBS, so I used to go to the surgery posting and used to see Dr. Shyam Singla. So that was my inspiration to become a surgeon. That time I have never thought that I will be a urologist or I will be a transplant. But my passion of becoming a surgeon has come from Dr. Shyam Singla. And it was a great honor for me. Today I am a student of him. And I am so capable because of all his blessings and my university and my teacher's blessing ki I am in front of you. So today what we want to discuss, and I thank you all dignitaries on the front rows and my friends, students, and my colleagues who spare the valuable time, and how much of us are aware about blood donation. Please raise your hand. I'm not talking about organ donation, the blood donation. How many of you are aware about blood donation? I think everyone. And how many of you are aware about organ donation? So very few. So why is this so much gap? Because we are aware about blood donation, but we are not aware about the organ donation. I think we are at the fault as a transplant surgeon, as our medical teachers and medical profession that we are not able to. So it is the today's need that we should be aware about what is the organ donation and how we do it. So it is my warm welcome from my institute right now, the VPS Rockland Hospital, where I'm working. This is a 550-bedded hospital, and we cater all kind of the specialties here. So organ donation, our today's topic is that how everyone of us can become a part of it and can contribute to it. So during my talk, we will able to answer all these questions. That is, what is the organ donation? Who can donate? And why it is needed to donate the organs? What is the rate limiting factor which not leading to this noble work to happen? And why, how this organ donation is done? And then after organ donation, how is this transplant of multiple organs are done? So if we talk about the organ donation, it is the just removal of an organ from one person to another who is in the deficient of that organ, either organ failure patient or absent. But if we talk about donor, so my in our Indian scenario, 95% patients are live-related. Only 5% patients are getting from the cadaver donation. In our India, the system is opt-in system. That is, when we want to donate, we have to write down our consent. But in Western countries, it is an opt-out system, that we need not to be signed for the consent. It is a government property. Our body is a government property when we are in the sick or in the brain death position where our survival is not possible. So it is a property of the government. So until unless we give them in written that don't remove my organs, so they will not remove. Otherwise, it will be accepted, yes, it is a government property and it is for the need for other patient. So that is the system that is followed outside. That's why there is the 95% transplant is occurring in America or in other big Western countries like cadaveric organ transplant. But we as an Indian, because our society is very helpful, our relations with family is very good, so we are still dependent on live-related transplant. So as we know that blood is not made, till now there is so much research has gone that nobody has able to make the blood into the factories, like same into the organ failure. No organ can be made in any factory, so organ has to come from a patient or from a donor who is having organs. And for organ failure treatment, it is must to replace with the good organs only. So there is definitive cure after the transplant. And so organ we have to get from the body. And that is the, anybody has seen like any this kind of box which is carrying organ? I think it will be in the movies or it into the media that anybody has seen, but not physically, nobody has seen. Because now everybody would have seen the cold boxes carrying the blood unit, but nobody has seen the boxes like this who is carrying the organs. But I think with the soon our awareness will be created, so we will be having this kind of the boxes available. So organ donation, but we can donate. We can donate the tissue from the starting from the eyes. Eyes, we remove only the cornea. Other the solid organs, we are talking about the solid organ donation today. So that are the lung, heart, liver, two kidneys, pancreas, small intestine. These are the solid organs. They can be removed from a brain death patient who has circulation. He is not a cardiac death patient. He has a solid organ transplantation. So we require continuously blood supply in these organs to remove these organs to be healthy. So the patient who is brain death means, I will be clearing this fact in the further slides. So these are the main organs which we are concentrated about: the heart, liver, kidney, pancreas, lungs. So we can see one patient, if there is a one brain death patient, he can lead or improve the life of other 9 organ failure patients by giving the heart, liver, 2 kidney, and liver even can be divided into the 2 and can be transplanted into the 2 patients, or pancreas, 2 eyes and small intestine. Besides this, which we can take from natural death is that eye. Eye can be taken from any natural death even after 12 hours of the natural death. So we can remove the eyes. Eyes means it's cornea. I will show you in the video further. and the bone and the skins. They can be removed even after the natural death, so there is a time limit. So today the need of hour is in India, 10 lakhs patients are waiting for their getting organs. So there is a huge demand and the supply. If we see in all over India, if we see that there is a organ shortage, because our family consent is not there, we have a negative attitude regarding the donation, and there is a fear, there is a misunderstanding, and there is an ignorance. Simultaneously with the organ funding, about the government doesn't have any organ funding, there is a hospital limitation, there is no facility for brain death declaration, and the most important is our community is not aware about the organ donation. That is the purpose that we are here today, to discuss all this among. And in India, if we see, there is a no defined network which lead to this kind of the organ donation. So this is the latest data from NOTO, which you say that there is a failure and patient family even want to donate the organ, but because we don't have proper networking, so these organs are wasted. So you think that we are going to the heaven with the organs? No, we are just burning them. So these organs are meant for the earth, so they should be transplanted after the death to in another life. So we have to make a network, and there is a survey of public attitude that there is a less than 50% is overall response who favor that there should be donation of solid organ. 72% were willing for only eye donation. They don't want to touch their body other side. And if by religion we see, every religion there is a history and their willingness for organ donation. It's not restricted to any religion. So society plays a major role in any movement in organ donation, in any other issue that we are seeing in day-to-day life. So there is an urgent requirement that our society should be aware about it, and so that we can talk to the family about the organ donation. Now the term is brain death. Everybody knows that when the cardiac activity stops, so we say yes, now he is dead. But what about the brain death? Because it is a clinical judgment, and when we say the patient is having brain death, means it's not only coma, it is an irreversible loss of brain function, either the cerebral or the brainstem. So we are concerned about the brainstem, which has our main, all necessary, important vital organs function are regulated from there. So when there is a damage to the brainstem, so we say it is a brain death, and there is an irreversible cause of recovery. And we exclude, there is a committee which in any transplant center, government authorize a brainstem certification committee, which does regularly some tests and at appropriate interval, and then they declare yes, this patient is brain death and there is no hope of life, and he is not going to survive, so he is a candidate for the organ donation. It's not like we are living and we can donate. So as per law, only the patients who are brain death and after proper certification, we can take out their organ, and there is a waiting list in our hospital and in the central registry. According to the blood group matching, we call them and do the transplant. So the counseling of the family is very important whenever, because most of the patients who are having brain death, they are either young patients, they are road traffic accident patients. So talking to them about the organ donation is not easy for a medical community or a transplant coordinator, because at that time they are in the very grief and they were not prepared mindly that they are not, their relative or their ward is not going to survive. So when in the hospital any patient like this came to us that yes, he had a road traffic accident and he has developed the brain death, and so it's very difficult to talk to them regarding the brain death clearance. And second thing is, yes, we can take out your organs, and to talk about the organ donation at that point of time is really very difficult. So if our back of mind, if we have this kind of the knowledge, yes, after my life, this organ can work for others, so that time it becomes easy to counsel them. And sometime in our scenario, recently, last week, one patient from NSG, security guard, came forward her his wife has met an accident, and she was 2 days later in ICU was declared as brain death. So for one day they take a time ki that yes, probably she will come out, but finally they found ki that there is no hope of the life. So they themselves, because of our awareness activity going all around, so his husband came forward, yes doctor, I want to donate their organs. So this is the awareness and public participation and the society awareness which can really create a miracle. And like in today's date, we don't think about from where we will get the blood. If we have to get any surgery done, we have to go and do anything. So now we are not worried ki yes, this blood I have given, so it should be given transfused to my relatives only, because now there is a plenty of blood is available in our blood bank. So nobody bothered about ki whose blood is it is, and nobody bothered when he used to donate. But the same scenario, it was like 15 year back when in our medical college time, when we used to ask our patients relative ki yes, you have to donate the blood, otherwise surgery will be cancelled. So they say, I'm not a relative. So this was the scenario practically we have seen. Probably in this era you will not be able to recognize this kind of the deficit in the blood donation. So the talking to the patient family is really very difficult. So what we follow, we keep any patients, we make a reputation because the patient is in our touch from last 2 or 3 days, and we show them sympathy and make reputation. And we in first meeting, nobody talk about the organ donation. First of all, they have to accept ki yes, my patient has brain death. Until unless he will convince ki that he is brain death, he is no longer going to survive. So then there is no point about talking to them about the organ donation. So first of all, we give them time, 1 day, 2 day, whatever time is comfortable to them, and then they come forward. Second, in during this scenario, we found out who is the key person in their family to take the decision. Sometime husband, sometime mother, sometime wife, sometime son. So we identify ki who is taking care and who is more concerned about their ward. And then we recognize, and sometime we also came across ki that there is some anti-donation also in this. So we have to counsel them accordingly. And once they come out, so then there is a whole process of organ donation started. There is a legal formality. We have to inform to the NOTO. And there is a NOTO, is a national organization for tissue and transplant organization, that is main office in the Delhi. And then in our hospital, whoever is the transplant center, so they have a certified brain death committee. So that committee recognize and certify on the form that this patient is a brain death. And once they give the consent, then we call to our recipient ki according to the blood group matching, and then we send to the respective, because in a single hospital all transplant can't be done. Like if we are doing the kidney, so liver is not done in our hospital, so we inform to NOTO. They according to the registry call to the respective hospital team, and then they coordinate with our primary team about the what blood group, what is the age match, and the blood then circulate among the another hospital. Like one hospital is doing heart, one hospital is allotted to liver, and another hospital is donated for the eye, another is for intestine or the pancreas. So there is a huge coordination between among all these 3-4 hospital, and there are so many staff is working for this one transplant. And then very important thing is, once they give the consent, we have to make comfortable to the family, and the moral duty is more responsibility now it becomes to save the donor. Because this donor after the brain death can anytime go into the cardiac death, because now there is a sentiment attached to it and also with the society. So it becomes our primary team responsibility, and we work on it so that meantime this all organs are harvested, this deceased donor is preserved, because it's more responsibility, because you can't, now the life is not only once, it is another 8 people are also dependent on him. So we have to aggressively treat according to the parameters. There is a gross physiological changes after the brain death. So many of the patients who are road traffic accident, so there is an MLC patient. So we have to get the clearance from the forensic department. We have to inform to the police station, and police, according to the forensic expert, has to be in time the hospital when we remove the organs. So that is another medical legal part. And after the surgery, we have to send with due respect the body to the postmortem, and we have to complete all the formalities. That is the hospital responsibility. And sometime you have heard about that organ has come from the Ahmedabad, that another organ is flying from the Ahmedabad, Mumbai, Kolkata. So there is air ambulance. We coordinate with the, because sometimes we are not having that kind of the recipient in our waiting list. So we have to transport the organ by the air ambulance, because the heart has to be transplanted into the 4 hours. Liver we can transplant into the 12 hours. Kidney can be transplanted into the 24 hours. So the most important is the heart, which can be earliest to be transplanted. And so we take the help of police, in because in NCR region only we have to transport the organs. It takes so much traffic time, and so we have to call to police. They create the green corridor. I think you many have heard in about the television and the media that green corridor was created between the two hospitals. So green corridor is nothing like a plantation. It's like a green signal. So the ambulance which is carrying the organ is piloted by the police, and there is another ambulance is also for the waiting is going, so that the organ can be transported with least time and they can be safely transplanted. So the only thing is that awareness of organ donation will boost the inflow, because we have seen there is a huge gap about the demand and the supply. If we see all over India in live related transplant, there is approximately 50-60 centers in India who are doing the kidney transplant. So only after this much we are doing 5,000 to 6,000 transplant per year. And demand is huge demand. It is a more than lakh requirement. Every year 1 lakh new patient of renal failure added to our society because of increasing diabetes, hypertension, lifestyle changes. So there is only thing that we can meet the demand and the supply is by boosting the organ donation. Otherwise, many illegal things are doing, organ trafficking is happening, many things are happening. If we want to make our India to be healthy, so we all have to pledge for organ donation, because when they are not for our use, we have live our life. So they can be transplanted into the another patient and can give the life to the other. So only thing is that we have to be aware, and we have to spread this message among all our WhatsApp group, all our community. So that is how we all can contribute toward the organ donation. So last year we used to continue this kind of the awareness activity. We thought like in medical profession we all should be a part of it. So we created our team boost up for all this awareness. So we have done many activities in different schools. Last year I was in Delhi, so we have created school, because we think a teacher is also a main motivative things in our society. So their role is more in the teaching, so they can convince the students or the nearby society. So we have gone to the different schools and we got a good response from them, and the teachers, they all pledged for the organ donation. This was another hospital or another school where we went to create the organ donation awareness. And this was my last year. This activity was done into the PJMS Rohtak, which is my parent college. So where all these dignitaries were there, and all like today it is was there. So we created the awareness last year into the PJMS Rohtak. And this year also we created in a house when we are celebrating 1 week of organ donation awareness in our hospital. So we did many CME in our hospital and drive for the organ donation pledge. So that our society, first of all, our society has to be medical society, and nursing staff has to be very keen about how it is done. And so that the first point of contact with the patient is the nurse. If we thought the doctor, no, first point of contact to our patient is the nurse, because many nurses, when they are doing the suction of endotracheal tube, they found that there is no gag reflex. So this is the first sign they detect. Sir, when I am doing the suction, so patient is not responding. So this is the first sign of brain death that many of our nurses in our hospital recognize, even after the doctors, even before the doctors. So that is the main point of contact. So we should be aware, and so that we can counsel them and save the another lives. So now I will show you one video. This is a video that we have. So this is the beating heart of a 17-year-old boy who had a road traffic accident. And after coordinating all from the team of the heart, liver, kidney, so this is in our hospital. The team of the heart has come from Meksake. So now you can see, normally one surgery is being done by 3-4 people, but this kind of the surgery, so this kind of the surgery is being planned because many persons are working, many team like liver, kidney, pancreas or kidney teams are working together. So you will be seeing the body is open like a book from sternum to the pubic symphysis. And now you see the patient is not dead. His cardiac activity, blood pressure, BP is all maintained during the surgery. So once the all dissection is done, now the multiple teams are working, the heart surgeon is working, liver surgeon is working, kidney. So once they all dissect appropriately, because it is like a liability transplant, we have to remove each and artery, vessels appropriately. And once they are through this, then we make the cardioplegic drugs and stop the heart and make the cool. All body is cool so that we can reduce the warm ischemia time. We reduce the metabolic activity of the body and the organ by putting the ice. We wait for some time. Now the heart has stopped. So now after this procurrence, now this is the heart which has been removed and it is ready for transplant. So now from, because it is not being transplanted in the same center, we have to transport it to the another hospital. So we are packing this heart into a sterile bag containing the custodial solution, which is a preservative used, and another bag is full of ice, because ice is not kept in direct contact with the organ, so it is kept in another. And after this, this is kept into the cold box, and then they coordinate with another hospital team where the recipient of the heart transplant is ready. So they say, okay, now we have taken the heart, you start removing the heart from that, because heart transplant is orthotopic, means from where the heart was, it was removed and put. While the kidney transplant, we don't remove the native kidney. Kidney transplant is not orthotopic, means we place the kidney in another position. We don't remove the native kidney of the deceased patient. So now you see the hurry of all this team, because the transplant team of the heart has to be retrieve the organs, and then they are ready for transport this tissue, and they are talking and coordinating with their primary team in the respective hospital. And now you see the one ambulance is going, and in the front it is piloted by the police, and another ambulance is kept or sent along with this for a safety purpose. So this is escorted by the police. And after this heart transplant team has gone, so another time the liver is ready for removed, and it is perfused. And because liver has 12 hours to be transplanted, and it was in the city only, so they were not in the much hurry. So now you can see that it is liver is going, and then the work came about the kidney, because we have the two kidney. Previously, when the NOTO, our organization, was not active and was not systemized, so we can take the two kidney into the same hospital of the retrieval. But now, as per law, we can only transplant one kidney or one organ, either in the organ into the retrieval center, and other organ have to be distributed according to the list, so that there is a mass coverage and mass awareness and no organ is wasted. So this is the kidney retrieval. So kidney were the two, and one kidney was transplanted into the our center. Another kidney was allotted to the another hospital. So that was again packed into the, that kind of the heart has been packed. And we prepared the kidney, we remove all the fatty tissue around the kidney, we prepared the artery and vein for the transplant. And because it was in-house retrieval in our hospital, so in another operation theater we have taken the patient of the renal failure, renal recipient, and this is the only the, we remove the cornea. So this is a cornea transplant, cornea retrieval. So this cornea can be retrieved up to the 12 hour after even the natural death. It doesn't require constant blood supply, nothing. So it can be removed after the natural death, 12 hour after the natural death. And only the prerequisite for cornea retrieval is that TLC count should be less than 12,000. Patient should not be in the sepsis. So this after the kidney removed and it has been transplanted into the right iliac fossa and the vein are anastomosed to the external iliac vein and artery is anastomosed to the external iliac artery and it start immediate becoming pink and turgid and it produces the urine. So because it was like a live rated transplant, this was our previous hospital team and after this the more important duty is to felicitate the body, to care of the body because they are the road traffic accident. We have to duly pack to them and give it with full respect to the family and we have to felicitate all their problem in the billing in the hospital and the legal formality regarding the postmortem so that they don't feel like many of our patients previously used to feel that after giving my donation nobody cares. So that is the very sensitive issue. To make it successful, this whole program, we have to take care all of the family as a our own family. We have to treat them with due respect and we should not hesitate in going beyond our boundaries to help them out, so that because the work they have done is selfless, it is a selfless service. We don't pay anything as per law for organ donation and neither we take anything from the patient who is receiving the organs. So it is kept confidential. As per law, we are not allowed to tell ki your organ has been donated to whom and who has donated for you and who is your recipient. Because sometimes there is an emotional attachment, sometimes there is a money transaction. So as per law, we don't tell them ki who has taken your organs and who has been transplanted. So this is in our hospital, ki whenever any patient used to donate to our organs willingly, so we used to go to their family and felicitate them. And our hospital used to give them full support for whole life, like insurance cover and OPD services free. And more than this, we go to their family and tell them ki the work, great work they have done. And we have made them proud in front of their family in their villages, because these patients doesn't require much of the education. We previously used to think when we started the program of cadaver transplant ki that only Delhiites will come for giving the organs, but it's not like this. In our 8 cadaver transplants, 6 were from outside Delhi. They were from small villages. So it is the intention to give. It's not your education level, that how much you have taken the degrees. It is your nature. Yes, you want to donate. You want to give something to society. So that he was only from small village from Didakla, probably from Smalkha. He was the 17-year-old boy father who had a road traffic accident. So we went there and there was also in our society the myths are when anybody give their donations, so their family or the villagers thought that you have sell out your organs. And by religion also we used to say that now these organs that you have donated will not be born again with that, there will be that deficient. So we have to remove our myths about the organ donation and we have to come forward for all this. After a few months after first cadaver, this was our second, she was from Gohana, small town, and their family was very motivated. They have said that my mother, because after death, one thing point I forgot, because in live related transplant, the patient or the donor has to give themselves their consent. Because now he's on brain death, so he or she can't give the consent. Only their family member can give the consent. Even if you have blessed today that yes, I want to give my organs after my brain death. So until unless your family will give consent, we can't take as per law. Only we can show them ki yes, it was their willingness. So we can counsel them, yes, they have pledged for organ donation. So what is your opinion? So then the most of the family come forward ki yes, it was their willingness. So we want to be part of it. So, but after the death, the consent of their family relative is very important and we have to take it. And in this Bimla patient was very, whole his life, she had a brain hemorrhage and after that she developed the, it's not road traffic accident, so brain death, brain hemorrhage, and she developed the brain death. And then their family, especially their son-in-law and daughter came forward, ki yes, we want to donate my mother's organ. So that was the nice, and then we went to their house at the Tervi, we used to say in our traditional. So then we felicitate them. So my request you all to spread this message all among your society, among your colleagues, among your WhatsApp group, so that we can make our India to be more healthy, and nobody should waste their organs after the life. So this is the donor card. Once you pledge for organ donation, it is a Noto site, you can go and you can download the form and you can fill it, and then you will get this kind of the card. That is a donor card on which it is written, give the gift of life and become an organ donor. So becoming an organ donor is not necessary that your organs will be removed. It is just a willingness, yes, you want to donate. Thank you. In my end is my beginning.